Welcome to Secret Journals. In this video, we are going to delve deep into the world-renowned masterpiece, the Sistine Chapel Ceiling Painting, and uncover the hidden secrets of Michelangelo that were since lost to history but recently discovered. For those of you who may not be familiar with the Sistine Chapel, it is a chapel in Vatican City, Italy, known for its breathtaking art and architecture. The chapel was commissioned by Pope Sixtus IV in the late 15th century and is famous for its stunning ceiling frescoes painted by the great Michelangelo. Michelangelo di Lodovico Buonarroti Simoni, known by his first name, was a singular artistic genius, sculptor, anatomist, and architect. He was commissioned by Pope Julius II to paint the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel in 1508, which he would complete in 1512. The result is a masterpiece of Renaissance art and architecture featuring vivid colors, lifelike figures, and intricate details that continue to captivate and inspire people to this day. The painting on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel is divided into 9 panels, each depicting a different scene from the Book of Genesis. The panels are arranged in 3 rows, with 3 panels in each row. The center panel of the ceiling is the most famous, depicting God creating Adam. The other panels show various scenes from the creation story, such as the separation of light from darkness, the creation of the sun and moon, and the creation of Eve. To achieve the masterpiece, Michelangelo used a fresco painting method, which involves painting directly onto wet plaster. This technique requires the artist to work quickly, as the plaster dries relatively quickly. Michelangelo was known for his ability to work quickly and efficiently, and this allowed him to complete the painting in just 4 years. While the world has come to marvel at one of the most iconic paintings of all time, what you may not know is that Michelangelo concealed a series of symbols and secret messages in his most famous painting. The creation of Adam scene in the Sistine Chapel ceiling painting is undoubtedly one of the most iconic and recognizable paintings in the world. It depicts the moment when God breathes life into Adam, creating the first man. But as we know, things are never quite as they seem, and the Sistine Chapel ceiling painting is no exception. Michelangelo, a master of hidden messages and symbolism, managed to sneak in a secret message in his painting, one that has only recently been uncovered. So what is this hidden message? Well, it's the shape of a brain, cleverly disguised in the painting. If you look closely at the section where God and Adam are touching fingertips, you can see that the outline of the figures and the surrounding drapery create a shape that closely resembles a human brain. But why did Michelangelo hide the shape of a brain in his painting? Well, there are several theories surrounding this mystery. Firstly, some art historians believe that Michelangelo was trying to make a statement about the power of the human mind. The brain, after all, is the seat of intelligence and creativity, and by incorporating it into his painting, Michelangelo may have been trying to emphasize the importance of these qualities. Others believe that the hidden brain represents Michelangelo's frustration with the limitations of the human body. As an artist, Michelangelo was obsessed with the idea of perfection, and the human body was his canvas. By including the brain, he may have been trying to convey his belief that the true essence of humanity lies not in the physical body, but in the mind. But there's another theory that suggests a more sinister explanation for the hidden brain. Some conspiracy theorists believe that Michelangelo was trying to convey a secret message, one that was only meant to be understood by a select few. Perhaps the brain might not be the most mind-blowing revelation of this painting, but there are many more intriguing details the Sistine Chapel ceiling holds. In fact, some experts believe that Michelangelo may have embedded hidden messages and subversive themes within the painting, specifically in the family groups that flank the prophets and sibyls. Many art historians and scholars believe that these family groups represent Jews throughout history, waiting for the return of Jesus. However, a new interpretation has emerged from a paper published in the journal Clinical Anatomy. According to this theory, Michelangelo may have been making a statement about the role of women in the Catholic Church. By placing maternal figures at the center of these family groups, Michelangelo could be attempting to show that it is women who keep the faith and family descendancy alive. Furthermore, these powerful mother figures are positioned in the male version of the triangle, pointing upwards, thus balancing the spiritual growth of the human family from its mothers and fathers, and creating an image of perfect balance through the use of the triangle. This interpretation is consistent with Michelangelo's other depictions of women in the fresco, many of whom are painted in an overly muscular way, highlighting female strength at a time when many theologians still debated whether women possessed souls. But why would Michelangelo, a devout Catholic, attempt to subvert the teachings of his own church in such a way? The answer may lie in the political and social context of his time. At the time he was working on the Sistine Chapel, the church was in the midst of a power struggle with the papal states, and Julius II, who commissioned the painting, was known for his authoritarian rule and his desire to create a grand and powerful papacy. Michelangelo, on the other hand, was a humanist who believed in the power of reason and the potential of human beings. His art was a reflection of these beliefs, and he used it to challenge the dominant ideas of his time. In the case of the Sistine Chapel, Michelangelo may have been using his art to challenge the church's patriarchal hierarchy and promote a more egalitarian society. By highlighting the strength and importance of women, he was attempting to shift the balance of power away from the male-dominated church and towards a more inclusive and democratic society. However, not everyone is convinced that Michelangelo intended to convey a subversive message through his art. Some scholars argue that he was simply representing the biblical stories as they were told, without any hidden messages or agendas. Others even believe that the notion of a subversive Michelangelo is a modern invention, born out of our own desire to see the artist as a rebellious iconoclast rather than a faithful servant of the church. Even more controversial is the Last Judgment painting covering the whole altar wall of the Sistine Chapel. At first glance, the Last Judgment may seem like a typical religious painting depicting scenes from the Book of Genesis and the final judgment of all humanity. However, upon closer inspection, we can see that there is much more to this painting than meets the eye. Michelangelo, who was known for his realism and attention to detail, painted the figures in the fresco in a way that some found to be scandalous. Nudes, both male and female, were prominently featured in the painting, and many felt that it was inappropriate to have such images in a holy place. But the question is, why did Michelangelo choose to include such controversial images in his work? One theory is that Michelangelo was using the nudes to convey a deeper meaning about the nature of humanity and spirituality. In Renaissance art, nudity was often used as a symbol of purity and innocence, representing the human soul in its natural state. By including nudes in the Last Judgment, Michelangelo may have been suggesting that true spirituality can only be found when we strip away the material trappings of society and connect with our inner selves. Another theory is that Michelangelo's use of nudes was a deliberate challenge to the authority of the Catholic Church. At the time, the Church was in the midst of the Counter-Reformation, a period of renewed focus on religious doctrine and discipline. Michelangelo, who had grown disillusioned with the Church, may have been using his art as a way to express his frustration with the institution and its rigid beliefs. This theme is also present in Michelangelo's depiction of Christ himself. Unlike other depictions of Christ in religious art, Michelangelo's Christ is not surrounded by a halo or any other symbols of divinity. Instead, he is depicted as a powerful figure, with bulging muscles and a stern expression. This depiction of Christ was meant to convey Michelangelo's belief that the path to God could be found not through the church, but through personal connection and direct communication with the divine. Michelangelo's belief in spiritualism, which emphasized the individual connection with God, was not well received by the Catholic Church. Pope Pius IV, who was in power at the time, saw the Last Judgment as a direct challenge to the authority of the church and condemned Michelangelo's beliefs. In response to the controversy surrounding the painting, the Pope ordered that drapery and loincloth be painted over the nudes in the fresco. Michelangelo, who was fiercely proud of his work, was incensed by this decision and reportedly said that the Pope was out of touch with reality. Despite the Church's condemnation, Michelangelo's belief in spiritualism remained strong. He continued to paint and create art until his death, and his legacy as one of the greatest artists of all time continues to inspire and captivate audiences today. But there is one final intriguing theory about the Last Judgment that we must explore. Some art historians believe that Michelangelo may have hidden secret messages within the painting, messages that were intended to convey his true beliefs about the church and the nature of humanity. For example, in the lower left-hand corner of the painting, there is a figure that is often identified as Saint Bartholomew. In this depiction, Bartholomew is shown holding a piece of skin that has been flayed from his body. Some believe that this gruesome image is actually a self-portrait of Michelangelo, a symbol of the artist's own suffering and frustration with the church. The symbolism here is that the artist was revealing his own inner turmoil and struggle with the church's teachings, which he believed to be superficial and self-serving. Another interesting aspect of the Last Judgment is the inclusion of pagan figures alongside Christian ones. The painting features figures from Greek and Roman mythology, such as Charon, the ferryman of the dead, and Minos, the judge of the underworld. Michelangelo's inclusion of these figures may have been a deliberate choice to challenge the church's strict adherence to Christian doctrine and to suggest that there is wisdom to be found in other belief systems. Moreover, some experts have also noted that the Last Judgment's composition appears to be heavily influenced by ancient Egyptian art, particularly in its use of diagonal lines and hieroglyphic-like shapes. This has led some to suggest that Michelangelo may have been inspired by the Egyptian belief in the afterlife and the journey of the soul to the underworld. This would further reinforce the idea that Michelangelo was challenging the church's teachings and seeking alternative spiritual paths. It is also worth noting that Michelangelo's struggles with the church were not limited to the Last Judgment. In fact, his relationship with the church was often fraught with tension, particularly in his later years. He openly criticized the church's wealth and opulence, and he frequently clashed with church officials over payment for his work. At one point, he even left Rome and moved to Florence in protest of the church's mistreatment of artists. Despite these controversies, Michelangelo's influence on art and culture cannot be overstated. His work remains an enduring testament to his genius and his ability to push the boundaries of what was considered acceptable in his time. The Last Judgment, in particular, continues to captivate audiences with its powerful imagery and complex symbolism, and it serves as a reminder that even the greatest works of art can be used as a form of social and political commentary. Still, there are many questions left unanswered. Was Michelangelo a visionary artist who was ahead of his time, or was he a heretic who defied the church? And what does this tell us about the power struggle between the church and individual spiritual beliefs? These are questions that we may never have the answers to, but one thing is for sure. Michelangelo's legacy as an artist and a spiritual thinker will continue to inspire and intrigue us for generations to come.